I'm very fond of wooden toys and so wooden novelties as well, and these aren't really toys and novelties. But from 2006 case, I found three items to show. These do wobbly wobbly actions, which I'll show a second, but the first one is what looks like an ordinary spinning top. Sort of tippy top, actually, it turned upside down. Made by Cornelius Wrench, a marvellous German artisan who I've met a couple of times. So this has got it's a tippy top, so it's got to have a heavy side, in this case it's a black side, and a light side, which is the top. I thought, oh well, it's made of two bits of wood, but no, it turns out that as a friend of mine has pointed out, if you have summer wood, it grows fast and it's light. In the wintertime, where there's a tree ring formed, it's heavy. So this is made from a single piece of wood, and yes, it is a tippy top. So if I spin it, start like that, and it wants to stay like that because it's heavy at the bottom, give it a good spin, and it will usually turn upside down as a tippy top should. Now it's spinning with the black side up. That's the heavy side. Do it again. It lies like that. That's because it's heavy at the bottom, like one of those little things that kids love. Set it spinning. And due to the properties of a tippy top, very clever bit of physics, it turns upside down, so the centre of gravity rises, but it slows down a bit. So that's one item which I picked up, and it certainly was new to me that trees have different densities going through them. The other ones are wobblers, but wonderful wobblers, like I've never seen before. Look at this one here. I've got a sort of do a thing to tilt it on. We'll see if I can get this to actually wobble down the tape. Oh, there we go. Yes. Oh. Bit more, fella. Come on. It does some weird actions. It's called a sphericon, this one. This shape is a very strange shape, but I'll just see if I can get it to actually wobble a bit. Woo, 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 woo. Down, down, down to here. Oops. Tip it around. A little more, sort of. He's doing a funny swirling action. There we are. Oh, I shouldn't have stopped it. I'll do one more time. Down, going down. It's supposed to do a little swirling action as it goes down, as if it's drunk, as if it's a little bit drunk. Oh, there we are. So it needs a different sort of surface. Oh, no, it's going there. But it's a very, very weird thing called a sphericon and does this weird lurching effect. The other one is much more customer friendly. This one was does a very, very sweet little action, blub, 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 like a little duck wobbling or something. And again, it's got some nice geometry to it, but it's just very sweet the way it performs, going down, bum, down, down, down. Don't know which way to make it work to go all the way down without falling off, but there we are. So not exactly toys these, because they're too much geometry and too much cleverness going on for children to enjoy, but I suppose they would. But they're really wooden novelties, and they're a very high order. That's a particularly nice one when it's performing better, and that worked well. And this was a big surprise. Did you know that trees have different densities? Well, I do now.